Well, friends, this is our English period, and we are going to learn a very interesting poem. Actually, this poem is based on factual condition. Whatever we witness when we live, that exactly poet has conveyed through this poem. So, name of the poem is Animal. Basically, when we see the name of the poem, we feel that it is about description about the animal. It may be some great characteristic about the animal, but this poem or this name of the poem says more than the title of the poem. So without delay, we are going to learn this poem, but before that we will see the information about the poet. The poet is here Walt Whitman. He is an American poet. If we see his achievements or what exactly he has done in the field of poetry or literature, English literature, then you can understand he had been given great contribution in American poetry. He had broken the tradition of rhyme and metrical poetry. Means he was not isolated, or he was not limited with the verse or rhyming words or anything. He wanted to convey something. He hasn't cared about verse or rhymes or metrical devices. He had been famous for the revolutionary poetry. Means whatever current situation is there, that he has tried to convey through his poem. Means poetry for him is the medium of to convey to the mass, to the people, what exactly the fact that he has conveyed. So his poetry was revolutionary best. His poetry is free from words. And this poem is taken from the Song of Myself. So, number of poem he has written in the Song of Myself. From that poem, he has taken this poem, that is the name of the poem is Animals. So, we have seen what exactly is the character of poet. What is the name of the poet? Walt Whitman. He is the American poet that we have learned. Now, we are going to learn this poem, Animals. So in this poem, poet has described the evil nature, evil instinct of the human beings. How are the human beings? How they behave with the other people? And similarly, he has taken, or contrary, he has taken the example of the animal, how they behave among themselves. That comparison he has showed in this poem. The name of the poem is Animal. So, first of all, we will read this poem and then we will learn word by word meaning. The poet tells about that he feels more at home and with animals than humans, whom he finds complicated and false. So, we learn the poem, we read the poem. I think I could turn and live with animals. They are so placid and self-contained. I stand and look at them long and long. They do not sweat and whine about their condition. They do not lie awake in the dark and weep for their sins. They do not make me sick discussing their duty to God. Not one is dissatisfied, not one is demented with a mania of owning things. Not one kneels to another, nor to his kind that lived thousands of years ago. Not one is respectable or unhappy over the whole earth. So they show their relations to me and I accept them. They bring me tokens of myself, they evince them plainly in their possession. I wonder where they get those tokens. Did I pass that way huge time ago and negligently drop them? So at the end, there is a question. It's an open-ended poem. So it is an open-ended poem. So we have, by reading that also, we can understand what exactly the theme of the poem. This poet has certain question in his mind that whatever qualities human being had, where are those? Means we have missed out those qualities that actually poet wanted to convey to this poem. So placid, so we'll see some new words from this poem. Placid means calm, contained means keep control, whine already we have learned, cry, You know, weaning schoolboy, that we have learned one poem, seven ages, first age, right? Second age, weaning schoolboy. Then sin, sin means what? Wrongdoings. So basically, when we do something wrong, so we call it sin. We call it sin. Demented means mad or crazy. Then news means low down, okay, to bow down. Token means qualities, and negligently means carelessly. So these are the few new words, and one more that is given here that we will learn afterwards. So these are the new words, so this will make you better understand. So we'll go line by line. I think I could turn and live with animals. They are so placid and self-contained. Placid means calm. So poet has desire to be animal again. We know very well that first we were animal, and then we progress, and then we become human beings. Actually, when we become human beings, it was great, blessing from the God, that we have got each and everything, we have got each and every quality. But now we are totally away from those qualities. Only we have got a supreme brain, and that brain we are using for some ill things or to do something wrong with the others. So when poet has understood this, that human beings are not remain human beings, they are so-called human beings. So he wanted to turn, or he wanted to live like an animal. He wanted to go again in that particular kingdom, animal kingdom. He wanted to become animal because he had seen animals are really very honest. They are not greedy. They are very honest in their relationship. They are very honest with their morals. But humans are not. Even though humans know very well what are the good things and what are the bad things. But they deliberately choose bad things. They do something wrong with the other people. That is why poet wanted to go with the animal. He wanted to live like animal. So I think I could turn and live with animals. They are so placid and self-contained. Self-contained, controlled. Once the animal's belly is fed up or filled up with the whatever food they want, after that they will never see again what others are eating. But what we do? When we fill up our belly, we think about our generation. We keep on storing. And in that, it is not the honest thing. We are storing many things, worldly belongings, with the different ways. Here, it is not like exactly meaning that eating or having food. No, different things are there. Okay, so I think I could turn and live with the animals. They are so placid and self-contained. They are self-controlled. But now you can see human beings are not controlled. They are totally uncontrolled by many other things. They have many aspirations. They have many desires. They have many ill desires. By this, they do anything, even though it is not suited to their moral. They do that. So that is why poet wanted to say that I want to turn again towards animal. I want to be animal again. I stand and look at them long and long. Why he said that? Because he has thought a lot about this. That when I stand, when I think about the human beings and when I think about the animals, I feel that animals are far better than human beings. Because they are real. They are totally, like a pearl. And we were pearl, but right now we are totally become black stone, we can say. Because whatever God has, nature has gifted us, we have forgotten that particular thing which we have got as a blessing from the God, we have taken very ill advantage of that. We try to conquer everything. We try to conquer nature, we try to conquer all the biodiversity only for our self enrichment or self-advantage. We see the second stanza. They do not sweat and whine about their condition, but we. They do not sweat. Sweat means complaint. Sweat means here, complaint. Not exactly sweat means what, when we run, then we get not done that. So they do not sweat and whine about their condition, but what we do. Now here the comparison between the animals and human beings. Animals never complain about their condition. They never sweat, they never have complained about their condition. They never cry, whine means cry for their condition. But we, if something go a little wrong, then too we become so panic and we keep on doing complaint. We keep on complaining to others. This has happened with me only, this happened with me only. Others are really very great. They are, you know, are in a very good condition, they are in pink, and I am always getting pointed out, I am getting annoyed by others, everything. So that is what the difference he has got. If we see the animals never complain about anything, or they never cry for anything or on their condition. They do not lie awake in the dark and weep for their sin. Have you seen any animal is not getting sleep, he is just away from the sleep because he has certain tensions because of the wrong doing? Never. They do their routine work, they have their food, and then they sleep without any tension. But human beings, whatever they do wrong or whatever something wrong happened with them, thinking of that, they keep awake till midnight. Maybe sometimes they didn't sleep also. So this is what poet doesn't want. Okay, so they do not lie awake in the dark and weep for their sin. So they do not. So you can understand here, they do not, and third line also they do not. So we can understand here, it's a anaphora, literary device, which is a device, anaphora, when similar kind of words have started for the consecutive one or two or three lines, then it is a anaphora, literary device. So here, they do not sweet, they do not lie, they do not make me sick, right? So that is why it is anaphora, literary device. So they do not sweat and whine about their condition, they do not lie awake in the dark and weep for their sins, wrongdoing, whatever they do, whatever they have done throughout the day, that is why they can't get sleep. Like that, animals are not. They never think, they do something right one, they are very honest, and that is why they don't have to, you know, keep awake till midnight or throughout the night. They do not make me sick discussing their duty to God. One more fad is there in human society. What they do? They do something religious work to God, and they, you know, make the propaganda of that. I did that. That is why I am here. I like to pray God. They make the market of their devotion, worship. But if we, on the other hand, we will see animal never discuss whatever they do. They do something good all the time. And why we say like that? Because we do something wrong. That is why we say that, how I am right. And when I want to point it out, that when I want to exhibit that how I am good, I have to discuss. Same thing happened here with the human being. And contrary, if we see the animals, then they never do that. So in the third line of the second stanza, poet says, they do not make me seek discussing their duty to God. Whatever they do with the God, human beings, they keep on discussing, and it makes me irritated, it makes everyone irritated. But animals do not do that. The many of the owning things, no one is dissatisfied. Who? Animals. Animals are satisfied. But if we think about the human beings, they are never satisfied. Suppose they will get one thing, they desire for the another. If they will get luckily second thing, they will desire for third one. Their desire never stop. Okay, and that is why no one is dissatisfied, not one is demented with the many of the owning things. On the other hand, this is the line for the animals. They are dissatisfied, no one is dissatisfied, all are satisfied. It means no one is demented, means crazy with the many of the owning many things. Everyone wants some luxurious thing at their home. Human being. But if you think about the animals, do they want? neighbor. They do not want. They want shelter. Even though they will not get luxurious or very comfortable shelter, they will live somewhere. They will never ween. They will never cry for that. I didn't get the proper shade for me. Never, they say. They live in jungle without any concrete buildings or sofa or some bedrooms are there. But if we get one of the hut, we will whine, we will cry for, oh, the other people have good bungalow and I don't have. So our desire for the worldly thing, we have mania, we have more force that I have to gain that, I have to control that. I want good car, I want good house to live, I want good ornament. But animals never want that, and that makes animal very powerful than us. Okay, so what exactly poet said? Poet said, they don't sweat and whine about their condition, they do not lie awake in the dark and weep for their sin, because they never do that. They never do any wrong things, but we do, we keep on doing, we never stop that. They do not make me sick discussing their duty to God. Not one is dissatisfied, not one is demented with the many of the owning things. In the last second last stanza, poet says that no one kneels to another nor to his kind that lived thousands of years ago. So in this stanza we see the fickle mindedness of the people here. What people do, what human beings do, they bow before the rich people, they bow before the strong people. Have you seen any animal is bowing towards, okay, he has seen certain person who is rich one, he had one car of 1 crore rupees. Will any animal go and will bow down, or he will bow down before his master who had given some mercy, who had given some happiness to the animal? Surely the person who has good qualities, who has real humanity, before that animals will go and bow or will show some friendliness. But what we do, even though we know that the person who has much money, much amount, but he had earned that amount in a wicked way, by the wicked way, but we go, we will say, you are very great person, I have never seen such a person like you. Why? Because we have that quality, we have that ill quality to bow before the rich one, bow before the strong one, who had authority, who had power. Before that we bow down, we kneel down, but animals do not do so, because they don't have any worry about their life, because they want to live in a simplicity. But we have desire something different, and when we have desire more than normal life, we need to do something wrong work. We need to bow before the person who is not good one. Actually, poet doesn't want like that, or poet dislikes that. Okay, so not one is respectable or unhappy over the whole earth. And for animal, not one is respectable, everyone is similar. Means animal always treats others like a god, as God treated us. God, no one is a favorite to God, no one is disliked by the God. Like that, animals are also there. They never become unhappy. They never become unhappy with anyone, or nobody is there for respectable for them. Okay, but we have category. Those person are very rich, those person have value in the society, they are respectable for us. But the person who is trying to meet both end within this day, that just struggle to earn bread and butter, these are not respectable for us. We have respect for those people, those who have much amount in their bank, they have they are living luxurious life, we have respect for them. Those who are wearing good costumes, impressive costumes, we have respect for them. So poet doesn't want to live like a human beings. He want to go in an animal kingdom. He want to be animal now, because he has fed up with these all things. He has fed up with the falsehood of the human beings. That is why. Not one is respectable or unhappy over the whole earth for animal. But for us, the person who is richest, is the richest one, is respectable. Okay, or he will not talk with me, I will become unhappy. Even a poor one or one needy one will say that you are a very great person, we will never pay attention towards him. But someone who is, you know, criminal, and we'll say you are the best person, but he is a rich person, we'll say, okay, he has praised me. We keep the DP, we keep the status with the people, those who are richest one, those who are minister, those who are film star, we keep the status with those. But we never keep the status with the person who is very ordinary person or who is very poor person, but honest, because we want to show status with those people. Okay, but Hanuman do not do so. So they show their relations to me and I accept them. So they show their relations to me, they show their love to me and I accept them, because they are very honest. They are not greedy like human beings, and I like those honesty. That honesty I like. That is why I accept them. They bring me tokens of myself. It's a very great line poet has said here, that they bring me tokens. Tokens means what? Quality. The so-called good quality of human beings, which have been gifted by the God, now we have forgotten that. And those quality I found, I got in the animal. I find in the animal. And that is why I accept them. Okay, they bring me the token of myself, they means they plainly in their possession. And I puzzle, I surprise that how they have the quality which should be in the human beings. Okay, not one is respectable for animal, or they are not unhappy for the worldly things. So they show their relation to me and I accept them. They bring me tokens of myself, they evince. Okay, evince means what? It means previous. Okay, evince them plainly, show them, exhibit them plainly in their possession. So you know that they never try to make drama. Who? Animals. But we try to make drama. We show more than our originality. Even though we are not good, we show good in front of the people, in front of the different things. We do the show off. We do show off. What? To earn something different. We want to earn some fame, we want to earn some money. That is why we do that. But animal never. If they are hungry, they will eat. If they want to sleep, they will sleep. They do whatever actuality. They do what is the fact. But what we do, we behave according to surroundings. We are very diplomatic. Humans are very diplomatic. And that is why poet doesn't want to live the life of human beings. He wants to become animal. So, and why? Because the quality of the human beings, which should be in the human beings, he has find those qualities in the animal. That is why. Because, you know, character is very, very important than your outer looking. Beauty will, you know, will be lost anytime. Will be lost anytime. But what remain? Your character, your nature, your good moral values. And that is why those values are not there in the human society. That is why poet, who? Walt Whitman want to become like a animal. Because he found their purity. He found their originality. That is why. I wonder where they get those tokens. Token means qualities. I wonder. Those qualities was possession of the human beings. But now those qualities are not remain with the human beings. How they have got? How animals have got those? Because they are very honest. They are not greedy. They are not partial. But we are opposite of the animals. We are greedy. We have many ill desires. We are false. We are living in the falsehood. We do. We show up a lot. We like to live in a decorative world. Or we can imaginary world, which is not exist. We kneel down, we bow down before the rich people and strong people who has power and authority. Even though they are not good, even though they are not actual correct person, but we follow them because we have habit. We want to earn something. This is what the great disease. We can't say that COVID is a very great disease. This is that we are not honest. Okay, we are liar. I wonder where they get those tokens. Did I pass that way huge time ago? Now I have passed those qualities. When we had those qualities, that time has passed away a long time ago. And negligently dropped them. And we have carelessly dropped those qualities. So this is a great question poet has put forward in front of us. We have passed those, or still we can come up and we can have those qualities and we can become again human beings. Now we are so-called human beings. Do we want to become real human beings? That is a great question, or very, very important, serious question poet has asked us. So it's an open-ended poem. What exactly what you feel? So this is the question for each and every individual of this class, or for whole human society. Did I pass that way huge times, those qualities, and negligently drop them? Or should we again gain those qualities? This question is put forward to you, to me also, and you have to answer that. So this is a great poem which we have learned here. We have found a comparison between the human nature and animal. Why poet want to live like animal, that we have learned in this poem. So if we see the literary devices through the poem, already we have seen the anaphora, because they do not. These three lines are consecutive, having the similar kind of structure. That is why it is an anaphora. Repeated, this they do not. And when any one, two or three, four words are repeated in consecutive two or three lines, then we can say it is a anaphora device, literary device or figure of speech. Repetition, if you see that long, two words are given there. So when two words are repeated again and again in the same line, we can say it is a literary device, that is repetition. Then we will go for the assonance, when I sound is repeated, vowel sound is repeated. That is why it is assonance. I think, I live with animal. So I sound is repeated again and again, that is why it's a assonance. And last one, metaphor, sweat and wine is directly compared to complaints. Okay, when anything is compared with something, directly compared, your line of the class, so it is a metaphor. Like that, sweat and wine is directly compared to complaints, that is why it's a metaphor. Okay, inner qualities have compared to tokens. So these are the, so this is the metaphor. So in this poem, repetition, we have seen anaphora, we have seen metaphor, and we have seen assonance. Assonance means what? When vowel sound is repeated here, I vowel sound is repeated again and again in this poem. That is why it's an assonance. So basically what we have learned in this poem, that we have learned that why poet wanted to become animal, because he has found the purity or serenity, or we can say, fact in the behavior in the animal rather than the human beings. How human beings are there and how animals are there, that nicely compared by this poet Walt Whitman, who is a revolutionary poet, and he is fond of, or he is famous for his revolutionary messages. Okay, through the poem he is not limited with the verse and rhymes and all metrical devices, but he wanted to convey, he wanted to focus, he wanted to express what exactly going on in the society. So, and the last, what he has asked, it's an open-ended question for all of you, that did we pass through the age long ago with those qualities, or negligently or carelessly we have dropped them? That is a great question he has asked us at the end of the poem. So what exactly I want to convey through this poem, that we should understand that we were human beings, and we are human beings. We should not run behind the falsehood. We should be very honest with our own identity. I must not behave like other people do. I must be very factual. I must be very honest with myself. Because everyone knows that if something is done wrong from my side, I know that it's wrong. We should not do for the people, we should do for ourselves. We should do something good for what, for which we should not repent again. We should not become so panic for that. So I feel I will convey you all that try to be very actual or normal or honest like. Try to be a very great human being, because this will live on forever. We never say anything wrong about the APJ Abdul Kalam, because we know him. Even though how was his appearance, that was not the matter for the world. But how he was with his qualities was really great matter for all of us. Right? So many, we praise Shivaji Maharaj, we praise many people here. We praise Sane Guruji, we praise many. Why? Because for their quality, because they were, very honest. Okay? So be honest, be actual, and no one should say that our total human society is so-called human society. We must be human beings with the all moral values. So I convey this statement from this poem. So I hope that you have understood this poem very well. So till then, thank you very much.